Hello again. Here we are at Piccadilly Circus. By Piccadilly Circus Underground Station. This is another station which was opened in 1906. The next stop on our Walk to Piccadilly line is Green Park Station. It's only a short walk to that one as well. The quickest way would be to walk straight along Piccadilly. It would take a slight diversion up Regent Street and through Air Street to get back onto Piccadilly that way. So we'll start by walking along Regent Street. Ahead of us is the Eros statue, and in the background, Coventry Street leading to Leicester Square. If you come to London, I would avoid that area at all costs. Right, so we'll swing left and go walk along Regent Street for a short way up to Air Street. Piccadilly Circus has no above ground buildings. The station has no above ground buildings. So here we are in Regent Street, obviously fantastic buildings here, owned by the Crown Estate. Beautiful street, especially this curve makes it even better looking. As you can see, the road has been narrowed since the pandemic, so vehicles cannot overtake at all. If you get a vehicle breakdown on Regent Street, you have to divert the traffic. Okay. We'll take a left onto Air Street. As I said, just a short diversion, just have a look at Regent Street. Left onto Air Street, that leads us back to Piccadilly. Turn right onto Piccadilly, we'll take us straight up to Green Park Station, which is another 1906 station. Lovely shops on Piccadilly. So we're working along Piccadilly westbound towards Hyde Park Corner, and the next stop on our journey is Green Park Station. Well, Green Park Station has turned into an interchange over the years, firstly with the Victoria line and then with the Jubilee line as well. Across the road you've got Hatchard's, famous bookshop, also Fortnum Mason, famous food shop. Okay. Blanchard's there, with the Royal Seal above it. And you've got Fortnum and Mason there. Let's have a look in here. Here you have the Albany, famous gentleman's residence. Gentleman's residence, the Albany. Diversion here. This on the right hand side is Burlington House, home of the Royal Academy. Burlington House, home of the Royal Academy. Okay, you've got a couple of arcades off Piccadilly. You've got the Piccadilly Arcade there, that leads down to Jermyn Street. And you've got the most famous one, the Burlington Arcade. We'll just have a quick look through this. Burlington Arcade. Someone with heavy shoes behind me. Right, we exit Burlington Arcade onto Burlington Gardens. Let's have a look back in anger at it. Hang on a second. Burlington Arcade. Right, let's walk back towards Old Bond Street and then turn left on Old Bond Street towards back to Piccadilly. Now on Old Bond Street, walking towards Piccadilly. There isn't actually a Bond Street. You're either Old Bond Street or New Bond Street. Okay, turn right onto Piccadilly, so we're back walking west along Piccadilly in the direction of Hyde Park Corner. Very busy here, obviously. Taxi, you can't be bothered signalling. On the left hand side we have the Ritz Hotel. hotel opposite us. Okay, here we are approaching Green Park Station. I believe this shelter on the south side was designed by Charles Holden. Apart from that, there's not much to see of the actual tube station itself. Okay, but here we are, we have arrived at Green Park Station. You see the sign there. Took us about 17 minutes, only 17 minutes, even with those diversions. Okay, thank you very much.